Hello and welcome to the Magic of Mathematics channel. My name is Manohar Murthy and you are watching one amongst a series of videos exploring the world of mathematics. In this video, I intend to give you a visual proof for the algebraic identity a plus b the whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared. I will assume here that you are familiar with basic algebra, in particular the concepts of variables, constants, terms, expressions and identities. I shall also assume that you are familiar with cubes and cuboids, in particular how they are represented and conceptualized in two dimensions, what is meant by faces and edges, and how to compute the volumes of these solids. Let us now get down to the task at hand. Let us consider a cube of dimension a plus b units. We know that the volume of such a cube is a plus b the whole cube. We know that this cube has 6 faces and it has 12 edges of length a plus b units each. We will take this cube and cut it into smaller pieces such that the resulting pieces are cubes and cuboids with edges of lengths a units or b units only. For that, let us take our cube and make markings on two of the visible faces as shown, such that the edges marked in red, which are of lengths a plus b units each, get divided into a units and b units as shown. Here, I shall ask you to imagine that we have made such markings on the faces opposite to these two faces as well, so that a fourth edge which is not visible to us also gets divided the same way. We will now use these markings as a guide to cut this cube into two parts. When we do this, we end up with two cuboids as shown, the first one having dimensions a units by a plus b units by a plus b units, and the second one having dimensions b units by a plus b units by a plus b units. It is clear that if we put these cuboids on top of each other, we will get back the original cube. If you see the two cuboids that we have here, you will notice that we still have edges of lengths a plus b units. So it is clear that we still have some work left. We will now take these two cuboids and make markings on two faces as before, such that the lengths as shown are A units and B units. We will again use these markings as guides to cut each of these two cuboids into two parts each. When we take the first cuboid with dimensions as shown and cut it into two parts using the white marking that we made as a guide, we end up with two cuboids. The first one having dimensions A units by A units by A plus B units, and the second one having dimensions A units by B units by A plus B units. Similarly, when we take the second cuboid with dimensions as shown and cut it into two parts using the white marking that we made as a guide, we end up with two cuboids as shown. The first of these two cuboids has dimensions B units by A units by A plus B units, and the second one has dimensions B units by B units by A plus B units. We have managed to cut our original cube into four cuboids so far. Let us now capture these four cuboids in one place. Notice that we still have some edges of A plus B units in these four cuboids. Hence, we need to cut each of these four cuboids further. For that, let us now mark up our four cuboids as shown, so that the markings divide the remaining edges of lengths A plus B units into lengths of A units and B units as shown. It is clear that when we cut the four cuboids along these markings, each one will yield two cuboids, resulting in a total of 8 smaller cuboids. As a side note, I would like to mention that 2 of the 8 resultant cuboids will turn out to be cubes, and we will observe this when we actually cut the 4 cuboids that we see here. Coming back to our main point, we can easily visualize that none of the resultant cuboids will have any edge of length A plus B units. So, this is our final cut. I would also like to mention here that as I present the 8 final cuboids, I will also be noting down their volumes simultaneously. Let us now start cutting our 4 cuboids one by one. When we cut the first cuboid using the white marking as a guide, we get a cube of dimension A units and a cuboid having dimensions A units by A units by B units. The volume of the cube is A cubed and the volume of the cuboid is A squared B. When we cut the second cuboid, we get a cuboid having dimensions A units by B units by A units and another cuboid having dimensions A units by B units by B units. The volume of the first cuboid is A squared B and the volume of the second one is AB squared. Now let us cut the third cuboid. When we do this, we again get two cuboids. The first one having dimensions B units by A units by A units and the second one having dimensions B units by A units by B units. The volume of the first cuboid is A squared B and the volume of the second cuboid is AB squared. Finally, let us cut the last of the four cuboids. When we do this, we get a cuboid having dimensions B units by B units by A units and a cube of dimension B units. The volume of the cuboid is AB squared and the volume of the cube is B cubed. It is clear that the volume of the original cube should be equal to the sum of the volumes of the 8 pieces that we have cut it into. That is, A plus B, the whole cube, which is the volume of our original cube, should be equal to the sum of the volumes that we noted down in the previous few screens, namely A cubed plus A squared B plus A squared B plus AB squared plus A squared B plus AB squared plus AB squared plus B cubed. Rearranging terms and adding like terms, the right hand side expression is equal to A cubed plus B cubed plus 3A squared B plus 3AB squared. And this is what we wanted to prove. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching.